The heterodox macroeconomic theory in the form of sovereign currency, a synthesis in ideas from Baron von Friedrich, Sir Moneywell, Prince of Utopia, stating clearly that legal tender is truly lovely. Hence, the king has proclaimed that the priest of the temple hereby recognizes the one they call bartender as legal tender. Any questions there? Okay. Well, maybe one of the elders can clear up any cloud of shit that may be splattered in your brain if you have any more questions.
Modest preemptive actions can obviate the need of more drastic actions at a later date, and that could destabilize the economy. Very profound.
This is not an issue of credit rating. The United States can pay any debt it has because we can always print money to do that. So there is zero probability
of default.
You're quite correct. To the extent that there is a central bank governing the amount of money in the system, that is not a free market, and most people call it regulation.
Well, he who controls the money controls the universe, whatever that universe may be. So let's get to the nitty-gritty of our conversation today. MMT, or Modern Monetary Theory, which is being promoted as we speak. As you already know, the Federal Reserve banking scam is getting long in the tooth, and the deep state is getting tired of eliminating critics by way of plane crashes. So they are looking for new ways of manipulation. What's this all about, MMT? Control? Power? Greed? All of the above, yes. Who is in charge? They. The 666 gang want to stay in power, and they will use every trick in the book to keep the ruby crown. But why MMT? What is the appeal? Is it a winnable con? Remember, these are all scams they're trying to perpetrate on us. They want to be the master, and we are the slave. But why don't we start with the appeal of MMT. Okay, pretty much 90% of everything we learn and know comes from copying, watching, and imitating others. We can even learn from tigers and the crane when we are implementing karate strikes. I mean, who is a better fighter, a tiger or a human? So we do copy each other. We learn from each other. I mean, where am I going with this? Okay, for the last 18 years, what have the young people learned from their elders? Think about it. I mean, they learned that you can print 66 trillion fake dollars and bankroll an endless war. Let me repeat this because it is the most important detail in our conversation today. If the elders can print up endless trillions of dollars for their evil adventures, I mean, why can't the young people print up endless trillions for good adventures? I mean, is that not a legitimate question in the mind of a 22-year-old? I mean, think about these young people. I mean, for their entire 18 years of awareness on this blue ball floating in dark matter space. I mean, what have they witnessed in the last 18 years? They have witnessed evil being bankrolled by fake Federal Reserve notes. So, in their mind, and we're talking about the young people today in their 20s, I mean, in their mind, somewhere hiding in the Pentagon's backyard is a money tree. Right behind the Federal Reserve banking cartel. I mean, they got some money trees in there, and they can just print out endless supply of money. And if this money can bankroll evil, why can it not bankroll good? That's where we're at today. So the 666 gang is using this ancient trick of good versus evil to stay in power. Think about it. Who is above the law? We talk about it almost every day. We know who is above the law. We know who is above good and evil. They are. Okay. So the pendulum is swinging back and forth like a finely manipulated clock from extreme evil to extreme good. And the pendulum just swings back and forth. And for the last 18 years, you and I have experienced extreme evil. And now it's time for the cycle to turn, or the pendulum to swing the other way. The problem is the pendulum never stops in the middle. It always swings a little to the extreme, left and right, good and evil. And of course, there's probably people out there who don't want to hear the word good and evil. It's not something they want to hear. They want to hear something different. Maybe they want to hear the psychology of change, that humans, we just get tired of things, tired of the same old stuff. So we got cycles of spring, summer, winter, fall. Maybe God knew all this, so there's change. Okay, but let's go back to what is good, because that's the scam that the 666 gang is going to try to perpetrate on us. They're going to try to say, okay, now we've been bad for 2 decades, we've been bad, and now we want to be good. Forgive us. We were wrong. Back in the Great Depression, the Federal Reserve even admitted. Back in the Great Depression, the Federal Reserve admitted, oh, we were wrong back then. Forgive us. Let us keep control of the money. We'll be better next time. We're going to be good now. For the next 18 years, we're going to be good. Well, what is good? Giving your brother a roof over his head? Giving your brother a loaf of bread? Giving your brother a hand if he gets sick? Yes, these are all good things. No doubt we can all agree that these are good things, trying to get the people out from under the bridge. But here's the rub. I mean, now we have, what, 6 billion little ants walking around? I mean, we got at least 300 million of us talking monkeys walking around the United States on 2 feet. I mean, where will the money come from? Well, the same place the evil guys got it. We learn and we mimic and we copy and we will go down together. That's what the young people have learned. Know your opponent. Know thyself. If you are going to criticize Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, the 20-some-year-old pretty little bartender, if you're going to criticize her and her money scam, well, at least know what she's thinking in her head and know what's thinking in your head. Are you one of those people out there, a neoconservative, and are you backing up the Federal Reserve banking cartel system that we live in today, which is called crony capitalism? If you're here to back up crony capitalism, well, you're going to lose, because crony capitalism is a scam. And maybe the bartender is a scam. See, I'm not here to tell you what's good or bad. And I'm not here to tell you that Bitcoin is a scam, or MMT is a scam, or the Federal Reserve is. You're going to have to make up your own mind on that. All I can tell you is that this is about power and control. And in the end, it seems like us po' folk, you and I always get the short end of the stick. You and I always seem to lose when I study history. But make no mistake about it. This is about power. He who controls the money creates the laws and controls the world. Okay, let's get to some facts here. You may be asking yourself, well, what happens when this snot-nosed little bartender sweetheart spends $666 trillion and inflation goes ballistic? Well, even today, if you have to go rent an apartment or buy food, you've already got a taste of that inflation, but you're probably thinking correct. It'll probably get worse when you get some little sweetheart in there spending a lot more trillions. Okay, But no problem, because these 20-year-old copycats have a solution. Now we're going to facts in the MMT deal theory, okay? Here's their theory if inflation gets out of hand, okay? This is not me talking, this is them. This is their theory, MMT. So they say, here it goes. The government will simply raise direct taxes, and by taking more money out of the private sector, this will reduce spending, which will cause prices to drop, and inflation has been licked. Well, they didn't use the word licked, but I mean, inflation has been corrected by government bureaucrats. And of course, they didn't use the word government bureaucrat either. You get the drift of it. They have a solution. For that big question, all you conservatives out there who have a question, what happens when they spend $6,666 trillion on all these programs and inflation goes? Well, like I said, these little sweethearts have a solution. I just told it to you. Well, it looks good on paper, but in reality, you and I both know what happens when you put the government in charge of the Sahara Desert. Yes, in 5 years there will be a shortage of sand. Thank you, Milton, for your fine sense of humor. So in closing, this is a battle over power and control. The 666 gang, in cahoots with the government, want to be able to continue to manipulate the economy. Okay? How many times have we talked about crony capitalism? And yet, our sweet little bartender sweetheart refuses to use the word crony. She always says capitalism is evil, but you never hear my little sweetheart say crony capitalism. And you know why? Well, you already know why. Because she works for the cronies. It comes down to power. I mean, this is as plain as day. They want to keep control of the currency, the money. They are losing control because all these children out there realize how evil the Federal Reserve banking cartel is. How did Bitcoin pop up so quickly? Yes, Bitcoin is an experiment that the CIA let go. And it's basically gone rogue now. But as we've talked about a million times, the government, the CIA, the deep state, the 666 gang is not going to lose control of the currency if they can help it. So we are in an experimental stages now. Everybody behind the curtain is watching. What are we going to do to control the money? What are we going to do? They're somewhat in a panic. All these children are going to Bitcoin. Maybe we can copy Bitcoin and we can put a government stamp on it. Yeah, they're going to go digital. They have to go cashless. I mean, this stuff is going to mind-boggling. But if you keep it simple, if you really keep it simple, they want to keep control and power over the money. And whatever you buy, they will sell you. Okay, so that's what I'll probably leave you with. Remember, you have to buy the product. We've talked about this before. When they throw out things like Bitcoin and they throw out MMT, they're only looking for your reaction. If they can get the majority of the people to buy their scam, they will sell it to you and they will laugh all the way to the bank. And of course, they cannot afford to sell you gold and silver and copper and pewter and commodities because they would be bidding up against the Chinese. The price would go up and they just cannot afford to sell you a good product. So they're going to try to sell you a fake product, but it's all about staying in control and power. So they plan on staying in power by offering the unwashed masses universal basic health care and other fancy welfare programs. Now, the reason why they're going to go with these programs is because it kind of kills two birds with one stone. Not only can they give the unwashed masses all these expensive programs and make those people happy, but they can also make their cousins and aunts and uncles happy. Think about it. The 666 gang, they have lots of cousins and brothers and aunts and uncles, and guess what? They don't create anything, no. But they need jobs, don't they? And they need a good, cushy job and a good, comfortable desk and a chair. Well, you know, in that government bureaucrat office. And they're going to sit behind that desk and they're going to hand out the goodies to the unwashed masses, the peasants. But guess what? They are in control. They are giving the commands. You will crawl into that office on your hands and knees and you will beg them for the goodies and they will smile at you and say, "There, you see, don't say I didn't do anything for you lately." But in reality, it's a joke. They're a joke.